Masak apa? Masak my style. Oh, wow. Alamak. Apa khabar? Alhamdulillah baik eh semua. I hope all of you all are in good condition. Alamak, good condition pula eh. So, today we're going to make something simple. Hari ni kita nak masak sesuatu yang agak ringkas sekali. Very easy. When I come home, I have a few fish. A few fried fish. Bila saya balik tu, saya dah ada ikan yang telah digoreng di dalam fridge. In the fridge. So this is ikan kakap putih. So ikan kakap putih is a white snapper kan? White snapper tu macam ikan merah red snapper gitu. Okay, awak boleh pakai lain-lain ikan. You can use any type of fish that you want for fried kan, untuk gorengnya. And then because I left it in my fridge, saya pun letak tu, saya balik kerja penat kan, I come back from work masih dalam uniform. So I want to cook something simple. So hari ni saya bawa anda ke pi balik kampung eh, balik kampung kita akan masak masak asam kedah. Masak asam kedah ni ada macam-macam cara. This kedah asam gravy have a lot of style. Ada macam-macam cara. Ada orang simplified yang membuatkan masakan ni agak ringkas yang tidak ada macam-macam. Okay, when they simplified this recipe, they took off a lot of things. They dah keluarkan banyak barang. So hari ni saya buat simple tapi tak keluarkan banyak, tak taruhkan sikit. So in between eh, dalam pertengahan. Okay, so something simple. Kita masak asam kedah. Alamak, nanti kakak cik marah kalau tengok resepi ni. Alamak, Isa. Okay, so come and follow me and I show you how to make masak asam kedah. In English they call it sour soup. Kedah sour soup. Susah nak interpret cakap orang putih ni eh. It's so difficult to interpret this Malay authentic words to become into to interpret into English eh. Macam-macam lah. Ayuh, so difficult. Can we just stay to as it is? Eh? Ikan kakap putih 3 keping eh. I have this white snapper fried already yang telah digoreng eh. Okay, so up to you whatever fish you want to use eh. Terserah pada anda. Ikan apa yang awak nak pakai. Tiba-tiba ada kentang pula kat situ, kot potato. Okay, so I have a bit of mustard seed. Saya ada biji sawi. I think you can put around 1 tablespoon. 1 sudu makan biji sawi. 4 ulas bawang putih yang diketuk. 4 cloves of garlic. I just bruise them. Saya ketuk. And then ginger, about 2 inch of ginger. And I slice into thinly. Saya hiris halus gini, batang-batang eh. Macam batang mancis. Like matchstick lah. And then bahan akan campak dalam rebusan. These are the things that we're going to throw into the soup. Soup base. 2 large onions I cut into cubes eh. Saya potong dadu. Dan juga ni chili. Chili jauh. Peppers eh. This is you know all the Angmoh call this pepper. Orang putih panggil apa-apa chili pun peppers. So this is one type of another pepper eh. Dia macam chili padi India eh. Okay. I don't know spicy or not, but it's green, but they come multi color. Dia datang dengan bermacam-macam warna, ada kuning, ada merah. Suddenly today all green, okay? And I have 1 cube of anchovy cube ataupun 1 cube ikan bilis. This asam jawa, asam paste, is a quarter, divide into a quarter. It's like one packet, one small packet. I divide into 4, I took away the quarter. Saya potong 4 eh, potong 4. Lepas tu saya ambil suku aje eh. Jadi saya ramas-ramas, you can squeeze it and make sure that it becomes the right tamarind juice eh. Jadikan air asam yang sedap. Okay, you can put a bit more extra if you like. Awak boleh taruh lebih sikit kalau awak nak. Okay, tekan minyak, heat the oil, put in the fried ingredients with the sesame, with the mustard seed eh, bersama biji sawi, bawang putih dan halia. Okay, kita tumiskan dia. We saute this for a bit. Kita campakkan garam sedikit, just a pinch of salt to bring up the aroma eh. Kasih dia naik bau, we saute until brown, kasih dia keperangan sikit eh, dah bau halia ni, kita smell the ginger already eh. Okay, now pour in the air asam, or the asam tu. And let this simmer, biarkan dia mendidih. And then kita masukkan cube ikan bilis ni. You can put in the anchovy stocks or you can put whatever stock you want. Awak boleh taruh apa-apa stock awak nak eh. Okay, this chili, I bruised it. Saya dah ketuk juga eh. I bruised it a little bit, saya ketuk. Everything all ketuk. Okay. so you can campur all this food into the soup. Semua masuk ke dalam soup ni. Inilah masakan-masakan old school ni semua macam gini, senang aja. When you cook the old school way, ha, it's very very easy. Orang dulu-dulu tak ada batu besung, tak ada apa, senang ni masak. All those people, the olden days, they don't have all the equipments, they cook so easily. I found this red color chili padi. Saya ada jumpa chili padi merah. I just put it in, just to show you how beautiful the color is, eh. Kalau ada color-color punya chili padi, if I found the colorful one, I would be so beautiful the color. Okay, kat sini awak boleh taruh awak punya apa-apa awak nak. We can put a little bit of sugar. Saya tahu gula sikit. And then to bring up the taste, just put a little bit of salt. Garam sedikit just to bring up the flavor, eh. Tak payah banyak-banyak barang, sikit. Just a little bit will do. Put in the fish, masukkan ikan. Kita masakkan dia. Dia punya bau, dia rasa punya rasa sedap masakan kampung ni. The smell, the aroma of this sambil meletup. Tengok, ha, okay. Itu dia masak asam Kedah. Dia, this is Kedah sour soup, eh. Ambil kau. Inilah cantik. Inilah lawa warna dia. Masakan kampung ni memang fabulous. Ambil kau. Kasih kat. Nah. Dah lah, dah boleh matikan, okay. That's it. It's not even half an hour. Dah siap. Itu dia masak asam Kedah. Alamak. Hampir mana ni nama saat ni? Oh. Okay. Big kau. There you go. Kedah sour soup. Selamat kembali kepada sesi Chicken Minyak Cake Makan-makan Eating Session Time. Alamak. Kau tengok. Big kau. Masak asam Kedah. This is Kedah sour soup. Ini kalau nak kena makan dia punya dengan sewaktu dengannya. Must eat with all the other partners, eh. Alamak, later you see what's a partner, eh. Inilah dia pendamping-pendampingnya, eh. That comes along with this kind of dish, eh. Kalau awak masak masakan gini memang harus nak ada petai dengan sambal belacan. Tiba-tiba ada, eh. Suddenly have, alamak. Suddenly have the what to do. Dah nampak beli. This petai is from another bag, you know, different bag. Sheng Siong got two type of petai for bags, eh. Dekat Sheng Siong supermarket tu dia ada jual petai ni dua macam bag, tau. Ni bag yang kurus, long, like a rectangle shape. It's very good, tak ada ulat pun, no worms, huh, this one. I don't know how it is, but I think slightly expensive, mahal sikit, tapi puas hati berbaloi, because there is it's not spoiled, tak rosak. Kalau orang makan-makan gini mesti nak kena sambal belacan. The blotchness, eh. Alamak, bismillah. Eh, kuah dia tak taruh dekat nasi. Actually, I like this mustard seed, eh. Saya suka biji sawi ni. Biji sawi ni sebenarnya kalau awak taruh banyak-banyak, jangan lokek, eh. I'm telling you, don't be stingy with your mustard seed, okay. If you cook curry fish or whatever with mustard seed, please put a little bit more extra. It tastes better. Memang masakan dia memang lagi sedap. Honestly, I'm telling you, I didn't lie to you. You all want to put little. That one shop. Itu kat kedai budget. Ini kita kat rumah tak payah budget. At home, no need to budget. Memang sedap. Power nak mampus. Sedap tau makan-makan gini. Actually, you eat this kind of food, it's fabulous. This chili, I don't think it's hot lah. Saya tak rasa dia pedas. Nak kena dengan petai, nak sama belacan ni semua. Memang go. Go where? I don't know. Go. Memang sedap. Okay, hari ni ada gosip. Today got something to talk. Yesterday, malam bila saya tengok news, eh, I watch TV. China News Asia. Talking about something lah, ada berbual pasal sesuatu. Then they went to a mosque, this boy and girl. Malay eh, Melayu eh, nama dia terpampang Pulau Melayu Malay. So they go do a research on this mosque lah. And this mosque, the manager, I can't remember. Walaupun the manager of the mosque eh, should have asked them, harus cakap dengan orang, terutama sekali wanita-wanita, perempuan-perempuan masuk masjid eh, pakai seluar, pakai yes dengan panjang. Kita masuk masjid nak kena pakai tudung. Okay, must wear scarf ah. Huh? I'm telling you. I go to Istanbul or any other mosque around the world, satu dunia. The Blue Mosque in Istanbul. When we want to go in, we went there as a tourist ah, huh? Kita pergi tourist. Everybody ya, huh? Asian, European or whatever, they ask to wear a scarf. Suruh pakai scarf and shawl going to the mosque. Have some respect. Okay, please huh? Mestilah nak ada respect. But the mosque manager, hello. They already tell you right, when they coming for filming and all that, you should ask them to tell them where mosque. This is not fashion statement huh? This is religion huh? Ni bukan fashion-fashion tau. Kau jangan main. Those girls went into the mosque. Yeah, they were where I, the other one I think because she's under production. She look like Malay, nampak macam Melayu. The manager should tell them when you come for this filming, you all have to wear a mask, a shawl, to tudung if you are Malay. Even if you are not, walaupun awak bukan, kalau bangsa lain pun, you have to ask them to wear a scarf to go into the mosque. Have some respect for our region eh. Kasihkan sedikit respect. There is no respect, you know. That is why all those children, you can't blame them because they don't know. Diorang tak tahu. Kita nak salahkan siapa? Kita nak salahkan budak-budak tak tahu. Kan? Cakap-cakap sedap pula benda ni. So you have to tell them lah. Please come. Wear a scarf. Whatever race they are. Don't have, you provide them the scarf. At the masjid. Huh? Other temples ah. Other religion ah, other race ah, they very straight to the point, you know. They whatever can and cannot ah, there's a do and don'ts ah. Jangan kita terlalu lembik sangat. Lepas tu kau nak marah orang, you want to scold others and all this and that, get upset over them, put this in TikTok and everything. Then whose fault? It's your own fault. Cik, cakap orang putih pun dah kepul-kepul. Because ah, this one ah, is on TV. Everybody see. My one social media. Not everybody see, but the whole world watching. Mampus. Ayuh, my sambal belacan dah habis. Sambal belacan finish already. How like that? Okay, so please ah, have some respect for our religion. That's why other people bully our religion, bully our people, bully our culture. You cannot accept the fact, but there they are. All these things are happening. Kan, dengan itu perkara-perkara sedemikian berlaku. Benda ni disiarkan di TV eh. Kepada anda yang nampak, yang kenal ke ataupun siapa, jangan marah, don't scold them. Just tell them, next time in future, huh, wear scarf. Pakai scarf. Okay? Even I respect, I go to more time. They wear a jacket, yang apa ni, sweater, ataupun windbreaker, got a hood right, got a hood. And put nicely lah the hood. Cover.
other country shows that. That's why you all when something that we know we have to tell them. They don't know, they won't know. Budak-budak ni kalau kita tak cakap, diorang tak tahu. So kita orang ni yang tahu mesti nak cakap. Kalau kita tak cakap, kita dosa tak? Dosa kan? Ada tulis kat situ kan? Kalau kita tak cakap dosa kan, dah dosa kan? So must sell. If you know, you must tell. You don't know, it's a sin. If you never tell, it's a sin. Ikan kapas, ikan kakap ni punya sedap, kakap putih. This white snapper. Awak boleh pakai ikan-ikan apa? Any other fish? Sedap betul kuah dia. Okay, you can add a little bit of sugar lah. Awak boleh taruh gula sikit untuk balancekan dia punya masam-masam gitu eh. Really, really fabulous. Memang sedap. Close. Okay. Before I close. Show. So I hope to see you again on Masak-Pemasak My Style. Mom! Jangan marah budak-budak. Okay. Please don't angry with me. But what I'm telling you is the truth. Saya cakap ni adalah satu kebenaran. Okay.